I gave you my heart.
Hi everyone, I am Cheseline G. Libiano from BPA1B. This is my tutorial on how to make a frequency distribution table. I have here an example of set of data. Scores of 40 students and a 70 items examination in English subject. So first, we need to find the range. We need to look for the highest and lowest value, which is 70. This is our highest value, and our lowest value is 3. To find the range, we need to subtract the highest and lowest value. Our highest value is 70, and our lowest value is 3. The result is 67. This is our range. Next is, we need to find the class interval. So, CI1. We need to put the formula, or we need to follow the formula, which is this. So this is our formula. We need to follow this to calculate our class interval. So this is our formula. We need to follow this and change the n to the how many number in our data. Next is, our result is 6.32. We need to round this to the next whole number, which is 7. This is our class interval. Next step is, we need to calculate the class width. CW. To find the class width, we need to divide the range and the class interval. So our range is 67. And our interval is, class interval is 7. Calculate this and the result is 9.57. Also, we need to round this to the next whole number, which is 10. This is our class width. Let's proceed to the class interval. We need to copy the lowest value, which is 3. Then, add the class width, which is 10. 10 plus 3 is equal to 30. Plus 10 is equal to 23. 23 plus 10 is equal to 33. 33 plus 10 is equal to 43. 43 plus 10 is equal to 53. And 53 plus 10 is equal to 63. Our lower class limit. This is how to find the lower class limit. Next is to find the upper class limit. Find the upper class limit, we need to add the 3 plus 10 then minus 1. 3 plus 10 minus 1 is equal to 12. 13 plus 10 minus 1 is equal to 23 plus 10 minus 1, 32. That is how to find our upper class limit. So we are done to our class interval. Next, let's proceed to the class boundary. To find the class boundary, we need to subtract 0.5 to our lower class limit and add 0.5 to our upper class limit. 3 minus 0.5 is equal to 2.5. Is 13 minus 0.5 is 12.5. 12.5. And so on and so forth. Let's proceed to the upper class limit. We need to add 0.5 to our upper class limit. 12 minus 0.5 is 12.5. To our frequency. So to find the frequency, we need to know how many numbers are in 3 to 12, 30 to 22, 23 to 32, 33 to 42, 43 to 52, 53 to 62, and 63 to 72. So to 3 to 12 is, let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 9 frequencies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8. Next is 23 to 32. 3. Proceed to our class marks. So to find the class marks, we need to add the lower class limit and upper class limit, then divide 2. 3 plus 12, 3 plus 12 is equal to 15, divide 2. 7.5. Next is 30 plus 22 plus 22 is 6 is equal to 35 divided 2, 17.5. Next is 23 plus 32 is equal to 55 divided 2, 27.5. Next is 33 and 42. Done to our class marks. Let's proceed to cumulative frequency. So cumulative frequency, we need to copy the first frequency, which is 9. Then add the cumulative frequency to the second frequency. 9 plus 8 is equal to 17. Then add at next is, we need to add the second cumulative frequency to the third frequency. 17 plus 8 is equal to 25. Then add the third cumulative frequency to the fourth frequency. 25 plus 4 is equal to 29. 29 plus 2 is equal to 31. 31 plus 3 is equal to 34. And last, 34 plus 6 is equal to 40. Proceed to relative frequency. So to find the relative frequency, we need to divide each frequency on how many number in the data. So 9 divide 40 is equal to 0.22. 8 divide 40 is equal to 0.20. So we are done making the frequency distribution table. I hope that you enjoy and like my tutorial.